Oh my God. There are literally more of you than my high school graduating class. Hey everybody, and welcome back to my channel, and holy crap, we are 15,000 views and over 150 subs from my last video. So that's crazy. I did not think that would happen. Thank you so much for all of your support. When I said that there are more of you now than my high school graduating class, that is what we're going to talk about today. I'm gonna tell you about my experience going to an all-girls school. This is actually the second take of this video that I'm doing because I originally filmed one version of this and then I kind of got off on this tangent about this crazy like drug experience that I had. So that turned out to be a really long tangent to go on. So that's gonna be in a separate video, so I guess you can probably expect that some other time. Coming up, my drug experience while at boarding school. It's a doozy. For freshman year, I went to a public school, and that kind of sucked, which some of you may have imagined from what I was talking about in my last video about living in a small town. I was one of only two Asians at the school, as far as I'm aware, or at least one of only two in the class. And that was not fun, and people were kind of racist when you weren't born in the United States. So yeah. If you're wondering why I chose the boarding school I did, it's because my aunt was actually the head of the school there, and so she had asked me if I was interested in going there. My parents told her that for freshman year, they wanted to see if I would like the classic high school experience, and then since I didn't, then I was allowed to go and apply for that school as opposed to staying there again. So I decided that I'm not doing that anymore. I am leaving and I'm going to go to boarding school because it can't get much worse than this, right? The application process for boarding school is very similar to the college application process. You send in your academic records and little thing about yourself. And I think I took the placement tests before I got into the school, so there's also those. And then after that, I had to go up to the campus and I did a campus tour. And then I had to do an interview where I went in and talked to people in admissions and they would ask me questions about myself and why I wanted to go there, and then I would answer them. Obviously, I got into that school or I wouldn't be here telling you about how I didn't get into boarding school. Boarding school is a really unique experience when it comes to education. It's very much like a miniature college, so they always talk about how they prepare you for the college experience. I think that would be true, but I then went to a really weird college, so it was less so the case. The classes are around the seminar concept, where you are sitting at this like round table and talking about the books and subject matter of the class, and it's more of a discussion as opposed to like a teacher sitting down and telling you all the information, though that also does happen on certain days, like when we would be talking about certain historical subjects, like writing on the chalkboard and stuff, but that wasn't like what the school's entire educational structure was about. There was a lot more collaboration and discussion in it, which was really interesting. I was a boarding student at the school, obviously, which is why I was saying it's a boarding school, but not everybody at the school had to stay in the dorms. It wasn't a boarding only school. There were day students and then boarding students. So boarding students lived in dorms, and a lot of the dorms had two people in them, but I was lucky enough to keep getting dorms with only the singles, so I got to live by myself, which was nice because I don't think I do super well with sharing a bedroom with somebody. And so they have these dorms, and then each of the dorms has a name associated with it and then a little decorative theme. So like, for example, one year my decorative theme was soccer teams for the FIFA team, so it was like different FIFA teams. And then another year it was characters in the movie Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. So there's just these different like themes, and some people will have like the Simpsons, and then these different themes would also go into like the first week of school. We would do these little skits after school, and that would be also associated with that. But each dorm was separated out by a hall, and each hall would be the name of the building. So we had three. So we had three different building names that the dorms were part of, and then there would be the floor, and then there would be the long and the short, and sometimes a T, which would mean that the hall was either the long hall with more girls on it, the short hall with less girls on it, or the T, which would be like an intersecting hall that would tie some of these dorms together. And then in charge of each usually section of the dorms would be what they called a house parent, which was kind of like faculty person who lived up in the dorms, and they would be there to like help us out or like support us or be like surrogate parents for us while we were living on the campus. Sometimes they lived alone, sometimes they had like a spouse or like some kids, and then all of them would just like live in this apartment on the dorm area. They would have all these different things that they would do with us or for us, and they just kind of were there as like a support system for us while we were living there. Also in the dorms were these things that we called alcoves, and the alcoves were kind of the gathering area for the dorms. We'd have at least two meetings every week. There would be one meeting where the hall would get together and we would clean up the entire hall and dorms and bathrooms. Then in the alcoves, we had a microwave and a fridge and sometimes like water boilers, and there were cupboards and girls would store their bowls and like spoons in there. It was more specifically an area where we could prepare our microwavable foods and snacks and things that required a little more work than just opening the package and just eating it out of the package. And then there's also stuff about the school that kind of was just like really strange, but in an interesting way. I would kind of be able to describe it as like a giant sorority. I never was in a sorority, but a lot of girls who went to the school would end up going and joining sororities while in college. There are special traditions and things that we do at the school. For example, every winter before Christmas and winter break, we would put on this play, and it was the same play every year, but it would get like updated or adapted. It would be different and unique every year because while certain like special parts were hallmarks of the show, there would always be something brand new and cool that would also happen that would make it different from the year before and would also make a statement for like the class that was performing it. We also had this thing called Ring Week, which is where the juniors earn their class rings from the seniors. And so the juniors would pick what they would call a ring sister, and then their ring sister would pick out different like outfits that they would have to wear during Ring Week, and then give them phrases that they had to say or activities that they had to do each time a senior would call out what was on a card on their shirt. For example, my ring sister when I was the senior was dressed as Charlie Chaplin, and so then on her card I said, "Hey seniors, ask me how I walk," and then she'd have to do the little Charlie Chaplin walk like down the hall wherever she was going. My school didn't have any uniforms, so we didn't have to wear uniforms, which was really nice. There were times in the past where the girls at my school had to wear uniforms, but while I was attending, we did not have to wear any. It was both an advantage and a disadvantage, because as an advantage, we could wear whatever we wanted, but alternatively, as like a disadvantage, we were all at very different levels of like social class and stuff. Some of the girls were there in like designer clothes, and then there were girls like me who were wearing like stylish clothes. Like, I was considered one of the better dressed girls at the school, but also all of my clothing were coming from like thrift stores and secondhand shops, and so while some people thought I was just really well-dressed, other people kind of looked down on my fashion choices because of the fact that it was pre-owned clothing. One of the really special things about going to that school is that I went from a tiny town that had like no people of color to this school just like filled with people of color. There were kids of all these different religions and different ethnic backgrounds, and it was just very different from what I grew up around. So it was really nice and really special being around people of these other backgrounds, and also it very much opened my mind in the personal sense to all these other religions and ethnicities. Actually being able to spend time around them and educating myself brought it to a totally different level. The food at the school, however, was not super great. It was okay, but it wasn't great. We'd have three meals a day, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then each meal was open for a certain amount of time for us to come in and eat depending on what our schedules were. The one major problem at this school, I say major in the sense that it was the biggest challenge for me other than what I'm going to talk about in a future video, is that it was a very hard school, and it was considered one of the most rigorous or the most rigorous all-girls school in the upstate New York area or like in the East Coast. A B at our school was the same level as an A at someone else's school. They would always say that colleges would weigh it accordingly because we had to study harder to earn that B, say, than like some people would have to study to earn an A at like some other public school. And that's fine in general, because like it is important to ensure that we worked hard and studied hard. The thing about going there was that some of the girls had a totally easy time with their kind of school system, and some of them came from other boarding schools, and other ones came from public schools, but like higher budgeted public schools. I didn't have that same luxury. I was coming from a small rural town public school. I felt so dumb compared to everybody else. Like, I had to do a lot of catching up. That was probably the hardest thing for me while going to that school, other than the fact that I was also then kind of affected by the fact I was taking medication at the time that I didn't need to be taking. I think those are all the highlights from telling you about boarding school. So, I hope you liked it. I don't have a ton of video plans laid out yet for what I'm gonna do next. I have a couple, but not a ton. So if there's anything you would like to see, leave it in the comments below. Also, if you have any questions about my experiences as an adoptee or as a boarding school kid, as an animal rescuer, because I also do animal rescue, you can also leave those in the comments below, and I can maybe do some kind of reading your comments or Q&A session. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.